next one right now.
The all-new clan. So proudly we all stand. A severed hand got tossed up on the land. On the coast of southern Ireland. The all-new clan. So proudly we all stand. A severed hand got tossed up on the land. On the coast of southern Ireland. Tommy O'Neill was full of piss and vinegar.
Okay, guys, hit that a little early, but that's okay. A little early. Sources unknown sent in $20 and four tracks. That's all it takes is 20 bucks, and you got like an hour-long portion of the podcast dedicated to you. Sources unknown. He hasn't been watching, but he has been emailing me, and he watches them. Something's going on with the schedule. He can't watch us live, unfortunately. Maybe it's on the East Coast. It is pretty late. This is Sources Unknown, his last track of the evening. Then we got some more coming up. We got four more tracks, but we're killing it for time. That's awesome. Beast from the East by Lost Boys, featuring REDMAN and CANIBUS. So we got my favorite rapper and Ignacio's favorite rapper on the same track, and of course Lady Poetic's favorite rapper is CANIBUS. That's how we met, is through CANIBUS love. That's how I met Joe. That's how it's all CANIBUS. It all started with CANIBUS. Nice. So that's fucking awesome.
Full circle.
Let's get into it right now.
Showers heavy at times with occasional thunderstorms today and a high of 89 degrees. Partial clearing tonight with a low of 74.
We come through like bulls, see us niggas taking two fools and pass. Nigga, watch your back once you talk out to ass. I pack a 380 in my stash for protection. Family to raise, the world is acting crazed. I never thought I'd make it, it was hectic when I scramble. On point like a knife, I'm taking life as a gamble. Living in the rotten apple, yo, but every core is rotten. All my niggas rest in peace, you see you gone but not forgotten. Now my main wifey, dead as shady chicks. Official lost boy since the year of 86. And fuck these crooked niggas, I could kill them with the passion. At times I feel like flashing in Jamaica, Queens flashing. You think you can fuck around, but kid, you just thinking. It's over when I'm sober, imagine when I'm drinking. Without blinking, man, I tell you, prove like pages. I ripped you from the backyards, park chairs and stages.
A plus, the lyrically superb one. Spitting rhymes off the top of your tongue to burn your eardrum. Rock shit, make the opposite team call a timeout. Knocking niggas three times, my size out, styles us what. So when I ain't around, they act for me. I buckle up and catch wreck like a crab dummy. For the fast money, I get up in that ass money. The fact you trying to test me kind of bugs me. I leave too sped up, like handicap niggas trying to get up. MCs get wet up with lyrical gun pellets. I blow up the spot when it's time to rock. I speak out, my voice box a peek out of the 100 watts. Who on the cypher? I get dumb. Word to my mother, the father, the Holy Ghost, the rap run. When the sword said it done, I end the service. Cocked in the type of verses, average MC work.
Yo, big dog, turn the track off. Yo, fake MCs, steps to the rear. Real MCs, bring this shit up. No.
Fuck how you feel. Fuck with the lyrical skills again.
My style is milk and magnesia. Clutch the 5-speed and bust them on your Maria. Secure the area. My life familiar is ultimate superior. We don't jack cars, we jack for aircraft carriers. I bounce like trampolines when I be blowing the beans to pieces. Him, I'm like sewing machines and Jesus. When the shadows of the barrel pointing out my boy Camaro, I get punished like Pharaoh for splitting. You better off singing Christmas carols for Christmas, because I'm on point like bow and arrow equipment. The president of chicken head conventions. I give you a deluxe Ku Klux legend. I got a headache from the stress excess. Not wearing the vest. 5'11 for being dirty. Courts are 9:30. Yo, Mr. Chief, I made this bitch call police. She tried swallowing the 9-piece, but got a warranty on false teeth. I return like Machiavelli on 18-inch Pirellis. Assault and battery like my palms is ever ready. Sharp as machetes. Matter of fact, I stop from cardiac.
The cannabis prince, the sickest drama. Fierce enough to pierce the thickest armor. I smack bitches for trying to suck victory with condom.
Playing with the mic is something I won't do. My only concern when I approach you is to roast you. I smoke you or whoever you standing close to, and make every man in your crew deny that he knows you. Defeating niggas like Seagull Steven, putting them C's in positions to prevent them from breathing. I make you question any and everything you've ever believed in, by peeping your deeper secrets like psychic readers. What's the matter with y'all? I splatter y'all against the motherfucking wall with these raw lyrics I catapult. None of y'all got the balls big enough to battle. I go on and on like Erykah Badu. 100 times nicer than the best is, twice as arrogant as KRS is. Who wanna test this? Fuck y'all, you don't impress me and no one can test me. The MC's so ill, I got any scared to catch me. All that shit you poppin' don't stop when I put you in a headlock and apply pressure till I crush your motherfucking noggin. I grab mics and push niggas to the left so fast they hearts end up on the right sides of the chest. My hypothesis is that nobody can see this lyrical genius. I got it sold like a seamstress, but if you wanna battle, I'm down. If you got 9 lives, I take 8 of them off your hands right now. Step up and get your neck cut from ear to ear. If you survive, then you can cover your scar with a beard. I'm the illest from Queens to the New Jerusalem, the Britics. Anyone who ain't feeling my shit, it can suck my did it. You need to quit it if you ain't spitting more than 50 bars per minute, cause you ain't in lyrical fitness. Kicking boring raps with metaphors, this whack. All of your motherfuckers need an order track to get you weighed up. Fucking with cannabis to get ate up. Beat down and sprayed up just for bringing my name up. For rocking longer than niggas twice my age. Back in the days before Bob Marley was rocking the fade. Before Honest Abe signed the paper that freed slaves. Before Neanderthals was drawing on walls and caves. I existed in the Garden of Eden getting lifted. Sticking dick to Eve before she was Adam's mistress. Before Christ created Christmas. I've been in lyrical fitness. The cannabis is spitting till he's spitless. 50 bars of total sickness. You won't forget this. I'm putting every whack MC alive on my shit list. Verbally vicious, telekinetically gifted. Took you a minute to exhibit that I'm sick with it. Now you tell me who you think is damaging shit. Going once, going twice, sold to that nigga named Cannabis. Me and Mr. G's A plus a phone doctor hopping after Huey helicopter to sue each of ya. Group home and death squad. 9-7, nigga.
And that was 49 and 50. Those last words were 49 bar and 48 bar verse. I like how they saved him a 48 bar verse at the end. That's fucking dope, man. I don't know if that was like negotiated for him to anchor it, or was it because that was old. I never heard that before. Cannabis sounded so young. He sounded like he was 18. You know,
it was
like
97. Like, so
97. So yeah. Cannabis. I was 15. So Cannabis was probably like 20. You know, somewhere around there, I'd say. I'm not sure how old Cannibus is. But, I mean, it was cool. I noticed, like, Cannibus is like an old motorbike. You know, like, once you get him going, he's unstoppable, right? Like, that thing will fucking climb any mountain. But it's almost like sometimes you got to kickstart a little bit. Like, he slowly led into that delivery. Like, he almost sounded a little nervous at the start. Like, maybe it's like, this is the first bar, and I sensed it. And then as you know, by bar 18, 19, 20, he was getting more explosive and more explosive. And if you listen to the bars, some of the metaphors that he put into the place were unbelievable. He's always been able to do that. I just get giddy when I hear Cannibus. I love his tone. I love his delivery. I love his bars. That's a solid, but it was old, you know, so
I get,
what is it?
He would have been 23.
23, okay, right. So, I mean, he was a young MC at that point, comparative to now. It's a long fucking time ago. But I'm going to give that a solid 8.5. Beast from the East, thank you, Forces, for showing me some Cannibus that I'm yet to hear. That's fucking awesome. Ignacio, what are you saying?
Yeah, I actually like Cannibus on this verse. You know how, like I said, you always
that was,
you know,
classic
how
Cannibus right there.
See, that tone of voice Cannibus and like that delivery Cannibus, that I could rock with, like that for sure I could rock with. I'm gonna give the song a 7.5.
7.5, Chuck, what are you saying?
I'd probably a 7. I think his verse was really good. It was really dope. That was cool. What kind of loses it for me is when I look at the track as a whole, his verse was so much longer that it just kind of created a lot of imbalance in the whole track.
Okay.
You know, because his was so much longer than the others. It was a really cool verse, though, and it was fun to listen to. I liked it, and he killed it. You know, if I look at the track as a whole, that kind of takes some away from it.
Seven. Lady Puttick, what are you saying?
Yeah, I remember buying this album back in the day, you know, Lost Boys sophomore album. For me, you know, like to compare this, like in the world of medicine or science, if we have breakthroughs, we circle back to what we called like landmark cases, which kind of lay the foundation for further advancements. And so for me, this is like a landmark track. This is an iconic verse, in my opinion.
Right. Yes.
Yeah, this is a 9.5 for me, man. This has so much replay value. I love the Lost Boys, love Mr. Cheeks, and y'all know how I feel about this. So, yeah, this does it for me, man.
9.5. Joe, what are you saying, brother?
Yeah, I'm definitely was feeling the vibe with Canada. Listen, when back in these days when Cannabis was on fire at the very top of his game,
right,
and you know, somebody calls you up and say, hey, Cannabis wants to do this track with you or whatever. And even though, you know, he's got 48 bars on it, you don't say no.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because, I mean, you know, the Cannabis was just dope from the beginning. You know, ever since, you know, album one, you know, I've been a fan. It's been great to work with him and all of that stuff, man. He was one of the nicest guys you can ever meet. And I mean, just fire ass bars. Every time he writes, every time he spits, it's just pure fire. And even though Mr. Cheeks and Redman didn't have any like really major standout verses on there, you know, the verse from Cannabis, you know, it really saved the track. You know what I mean? And I liked it. I'm giving it a 9.
Solid 9. The track is 100% say yes in the crew. So let's end that poll, and we will get on to the next one. 11, that was Forces. Forces, thank you very much. Let's give it, that was a little set from Forces. Thanks, Forces, man. You did your homework. You did your homework, and we really appreciate when people do their homework and dig deep for good hip-hop, because that just makes the show so much better. Thank you, Forces Unknown. Yeah, I have your real name in your PayPal, but I probably shouldn't say that. He always do it by Forces. I almost dropped it. And I've almost dropped Lady Poetic's name a couple times too, but I've done pretty good. I haven't done it yet. It's pretty good. Forces, Beast from the East from Lost Boys, featuring Redman and Cannabis. Let's get into the next one right now.
Do it.